First, I'm going to start by talking to Ken Hart, and
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Trench Grenade channel. I am your host, the Colt 6920 carry handle enjoyer that your mom said that we have at home. Today we're going to be firing from a number of different positions out here at 120 meters from these targets. It's the farthest I can get away from the actual engagement on this range to demonstrate some practical accuracy with a Colt 6920 with a carry handle, fixed front sight post, 1000 lumen light, and a T-Rex arm slings. Sling. Guys, this video is going to be directed at what you actually need as a baseline, and not to get all wrapped up in, oh, I need an aim point, I need an EOTech or something to throw on my rifle. No, guys, you can go out, you can get a carry handle AR or any sort of iron sights that are good, reliable iron sights like this Colt 6920, and you can rock and roll all day long with the best of them. So don't get trapped up and wrapped up in this freaking, I need an aim point, I need an EOTech, or LPVO for my rifle. You do not. Your carbine can run just fine with a setup like this. I have a 25 meter zero. We will be shooting, like I said, at 120 meters. Okay, guys, the sponsor for today's video is Palmetto State Armory. Okay, guys, use the link below, head over to PSA, buy their Saber 15 or any of their retro rifles, their H&R rifles, okay? Get a freaking carry handle and just get out to the range with 1,000 rounds of ammo and get some training. Figure out what your holds are, and you'll enjoy that rifle much more than you will some Gucci build that you never are able to shoot because you can't afford to shoot it. So check out the link below for Palmetto State Armory and get something like this Colt over there, carry handle, and get out to the range and put some rounds on range. Additionally, guys, the secondary sponsor for the video is Mystery Ranch. If you need a good quality pack, Mystery Ranch is going to have your back. Use the link below. Get over there and check out Mystery Ranch. I use the green Assault 2 and the 48 hour, the blue and brown 48 hour pack that they have over there for the gym. So get over there, check out the link. If you want to be a member of the Discord, check out the Patreon. It's $5 a month. Gets you buddies to train with and to game with. And there you go. Hopefully that pays for some of the ammo that we're about to put through. So guys, on your carry handle, you have a 0-200 circle or rear side aperture, and then you have a 300-600 setting. Okay, today we're going to be shooting with the 0-200 as we are at 120 meters. My rear sight is set to 6 out of 3. Okay, the 300-600 meter battle sight zero. Okay, guys, we are only going to be shooting 55 grain full metal jacket through the weapon. I will have to adjust the camera a couple times to show you the prone supported firing position, the kneeling supported, and the standing supported. As you can see behind us, we have 4 targets. I don't have my shot timer because I was in a hurry, and I have to work right after this video. So, hey, you get what you get. You don't throw a fit, right, guys? So, before I forget, the drink for the video is Monster. Get caffeinated, get motivated, and make sure y'all are actually hitting the gym and hitting the range. Cheers. Okay, guys, like I said, we got 4 targets downrange. We have, let's see, 60 rounds that we're going to start off with, and what we're going to do is we're simply going to put 30 rounds per silhouette in each firing position. So it'll be prone supported firing position, okay, for the far left, kneeling supported for the next one, standing supported for the next one, and then we'll do I guess we'll just do 10 rounds of each on the last one, and I'll remember, and when we get down there, I'll show you all the target. I'm going to be aiming at the gut. The reason I'm going to aim at the gut is because at 120 meters, the round will be slightly high with a 25 to 300 meters zero. Okay. 3 lanes, right? with the 25 meter zero, you're gonna be dead on at 300. That means I need to aim at the gut. I need to aim at the gut at all ranges to be able to hit at all ranges without having to know my holes. Okay, but without any more talking, guys, we're gonna go ahead and load up and get to firing. We'll start with the prone supported firing position. Guys, I would rather all y'all go out, get a carry handle, some sort of carry handle AR, or good quality iron sights on your AR, and actually be able to put like 2,000 rounds through the gun, than you only having a couple hundred rounds through the gun, and then you never get to the range because you bought an aim point or something Gucci. If you can afford it, go buy the Gucci option. But if you can't, guys, get out to the range with something like this freaking Colt and just freaking go to town. All right, guys, I'm going to adjust this camera and we're going to get shooting here. All right, guys, bear with this unconventional filming as I am an 11 Bravo infantryman, not a freaking photographer, you know what I'm saying? But we're going to go ahead and load up. We're going to do one magazine. Now, for the prone supported firing position, for me, what I'll do, okay, mag in, pull down because you can, or release. What I do, okay, is I just use the magazine, and it works great for me. Make sure we're in frame. All right, guys, we're going to do 30 rounds at the target on the left. Guys, I should note the trigger on this Colt is very nice. It's very smooth. For my sight picture, guys, I'm getting a good chipmunk cheek, nose to charging handle every time. Chipmunk cheek, roll into it, nose to charging handle. And the reason I'm aiming at the gut, like I said, for a battle sight zero, guys, at 120, my impacts should be slightly high. All right. Now, guys, you're going to have to bear with me. We're going to have to transition to the kneeling supported. The way I would do that for those rookies, I would simply place the weapon on save, close my ejection port cover, tuck it, post point stand, take a knee before getting all the way up, and then I would move out. Give me a second while I transition the camera over, guys. All right, guys, so let's talk about the kneeling supported. So there's a couple ways to do it. I'm not trying to insult anyone's intelligence, but I just want to talk about kind of the way that I've seen done in the past and some of the ways that work and some of the ways that don't work. So if you're going to do kneeling supported on the outside of a building, you want your firing side knee up and firing side elbow to rest on that knee. So this, guys, would be too high. I want a low silhouette with my firing elbow on my firing side knee. Now, with a C grip, I'm just simply going to grab the weapon, pull it into whatever barricade, and push against whatever barricade or obstacle that I have. If I have a side of a building, simply use a good C grip, push into that. Now, I'm going to show you another method that works for me. I'll simply go what's called double kneeling, okay, both knees on the ground, and I'll lean into that barricade with either a C grip. This barricade is kind of rickety, right? It's about to fall apart. So I might just pull back like this on it if we're doing rangeism. But just think, double kneeling is another method, guys. All right, we're going to do 30 rounds at the second target. Thank you. Keep in mind, guys, we're not doing slow fire. We're just doing regular shooting. No bench resting. And it's right around here where I wonder, am I going to lose audio? Am I going to, you know, is the actual video going to turn out the way I want it to? We'll see. Okay, so what you want to do for your reload, as you saw, old mag out with gravity. Use your reload with gravity. As that old mag comes out with gravity, rotate your new mag in, pull down on the mag because you can, bolt release, and then get into the good standing supported position with the weapon on safe. All right, guys, I'm going to transition the camera up a little bit, and let's talk about the standing supported. I'm going to cut just for a second to make sure my audio is still working. Stand by. Okay, audio seems to be going good. So for your reloads, guys, simply tuck into your workspace, old mag out, new mag in, pull down because you can, then hit your bolt catch release with your thumb. Make sure the ejection port cover is closed when moving or when doing any sort of individual movement techniques, and make sure the weapon is on safe. Okay, guys, now we're going to talk about shooting from the standing. Now, simply, if the barricade or building that you're shooting off of is sturdy enough to support your weight, lean in all the way to that barricade. Okay, don't be scared to lean in. Lean in all the way. Stay with me, tripod. Stand by. Okay, there we go. Oh, okay, here we go. All right, so to work around, we'll back up a little bit. So as we're getting up, simply post point stand. What that's gonna do is enable you to create space from whatever you're working around. So if I was over here fighting, and I needed to move to you, weapon on safe, present, create space. That way, if I came around this side of the building or barricade I needed to engage, I could simply place it on semi, engage the threat, and get to my position. So one more time, when moving around barricades, okay, if I'm fighting, create space. And if I had to, as I come around, I'm short stocking it with the stock up and over my shoulder, but still able to maintain access to my front sight post. And then if I had to, I could re-engage when I got back to that second, that next position. Okay, guys. All right. So standing, for the standing position, left leg slightly forward, right leg slightly back. For me, actually leading into the barricade, C grip, not resting the barrel on the barricade. If you rest the barrel on the barricade, you're going to get a shift in point of impact because it's going to push with a non-free floated barrel or any barrel. If you're pushing up on it, it's going to have a slight point of impact. So try not to rest your barrel on any sort of obstacle. Good C grip, leaning in, chipmunk cheek. Okay, now this is a little high for me, but I'm gonna have to shoot it because of the camera. But you want to be slightly lower, that way you can have an athletic stance and actually lean in. You don't want to be way up here because then you can't get a good cheek to stock or recoil management. Okay, but this will work fine for these purposes today. All right, 30 rounds, third target, here we go. And guys, you want to fire at the bottom of the breath if the opportunity presents itself, because you can always breathe in more. You can't always breathe out more. But for today's purposes, I'm just going to simply fire 30 rounds and show you the practical accuracy with iron sights. Same fundamentals apply, guys. Start with your chin high, roll into it. Good, chipmunk cheek. Nose to charging handle every time. Okay, once you're out of ammo, weapon on safe, old mag out with gravity, reach for your new magazine. If you need to, get behind cover. Okay, new mag in, pull down because you can, bolt catch release, weapon on safe. And like I said before, you need to work around barricades, simply short stock and get back to that position as you need to. All right, guys, let's take a trip down range so I can show you all what we're working with so far with the prone supported, kneeling supported, and standing supported firing position with this Colt 6920 with a carry handle. All right, guys, let's move down range. All right, guys, what we're about to do is just do 5 rounds, confirmation 0, and I'm going to show you why in a second. All right, let's go check it out. Some of you probably already know why we're doing a 5 round confirmation 0. That's okay. So I put this carry handle on for this video, assuming it would return to 0 from another rifle. I was incorrect. So this is the group basically, and I'll show you why in a second, but I need to adjust this. We need to go up about 1, 2, up 2, and left about 6. And I'll show you why right now. So here was the standing. Okay. And if you can think, the up 6, left, or up 2, left 6 adjustment I just talked about, it's because we're grouping in here. Hopefully y'all can see those impacts. So this is the standing, standing supported. Okay, guys, the group is over here, bottom right. All right, switching over to the kneeling supported, same thing, bottom right, just a tighter group. Okay, so this is kneeling supported, guys. The group is down here because my actual 0 was off. That's fine. I'm just going to move it those up 2 left 6, and then I'm going to reshoot this drill. I'll just circle the actual impact so that way we can show it again. And here, much tighter group, obviously, for the prone supported, but as you can see, we still, that 0 is off, so I need to go at least up 2 and then left 6 for that adjustment. So I'm going to go ahead and actually 0 this rifle real quick, guys, and then we're going to reshoot those positions. That way y'all can see the battle sight 0. This is why you always want to confirm 0 before filming, but I'm tight for time. So as you can see, I was aiming for the A. 25 meters, my 0 is off to the right. I'm going to re-zero, reshoot. Here we go. Guys, I guess I'll show you. So for your windage, it simply says right is this way, left is this way. I just went left 6 clicks, and I went up 2 on my front sight post. You can use a bullet to turn that. You depress it and turn it. We're going to go back to 25, shoot 5 more rounds, and see what we're looking like. Nothing discussed in today's video should be taken as legal advice or as a substitute for legal advice. Always remember the 4 rules of firearm safety. Treat your weapon as if it is loaded at all times. Keep your finger straight off the trigger until you're ready to engage. Be aware of your target and its surroundings, and never point your weapon at anything you don't intend to destroy. The Discord server is live. Get in there, get some gaming buddies and some buddies to train with. The Patreon is live. It is the only source of funding for the channel. If you're interested in it, get over there and check out the Patreon. We could sure use your help. Thanks. All right, guys, we're going to very hastily fire 5 rounds from this high-speed barrel. Okay, we're gonna aim at the chest. A, here we go, 5 rounds. And I can already see the impacts. We're still way low and way right, so we're gonna go left. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up. We're gonna go up 1. So that, my 0 was pretty far off here, guys. I'm going to go up 1. Okay, up 1, and let's reshoot. Okay. I'm going to say up 1, left 2. Left 2. Up. One. Okay. Make sure it's actually locked in. Okay. Up to left one, reshoot. Okay, I'm gonna go show y'all. Guys, again, we are rushed for time, but so I wanna make sure y'all get some good content or at least something here. All right, so on that last group, this is my first group coming up, and then we had one right here, went up one, left two. Now we're slightly high. I think we're still slightly right, so I still need to go left one. Left one, and that should, we'll do a few more rounds at this A for confirmation zero real quick, and then we will go back and reshoot a few drills, and then we'll get you all off out of here. Guys, reminder, Patreon, PSA, and Mystery Ranch, check them out in the description below if you want to help pay for this ammo that we are out here actively burning. All right, here we go. Confirmation zero at the A head box. And yes, guys, you want to be in a good prone supported firing position when zeroing. We are rushed for time. This is what you got. Okay, let's go check it out, guys. Crazy what happens when your rifle is actually zeroed, huh? All right, this is that last group. So, good enough for me. Maybe should go down one, but we're going to leave it. This is that last group again. All right, we're going to go back, and what we're going to do, we'll shoot 10 rounds for each of these, so memorize it. 10 rounds for each of these targets, okay? This one's clean. This one's clean. And this one's clean. All right, we're going to move back out to 120, fire 10 rounds per, and then close out this video. All right, guys, we're back here at 120. We're going to shoot 15 rounds from the kneeling, 15 from the standing, and I'm whole mag from the prone. And then we're going to wrap out this video, guys. Of course, y'all are not going to be able to see. How about this? Boom. Okay. Here we go. We'll do same thing. The middle target is going to be the kneeling, and then the next one will be the standing. I'll show y'all when we get down there. Here we go. Okay, I think that was four rounds. Okay, that was roughly 12 rounds. We're going to transition up to the standing for y'all. All right, here we go. As you can tell, guys, I'm tight for time here. Okay, standing. We'll do a good 10 rounds standing. Okay, and the rest we're going to shoot in the prone for y'all to show you some accuracy with iron sights. Standby. All right, guys, last few rounds of the day. We'll fire whatever we got left in these two magazines, and that'll be it for the day. Guys, reminder, check out the description below if you want to help support the channel. Last few rounds of the day from technically the prone unsupported, but I'm gonna fire it from the magazine and we're gonna call it prone supported. Here we go. Make sure y'all can see, y'all can see. Here we go. All right, 30 more rounds on the targets. Okay, we are clear. All right. Nice. Okay, let's go down range. All right, guys, we're down here at the target. This is going to be a better representation. So that's your prone supported firing position, okay? Aiming to the gut, grooving right here. So obviously my zero is still slightly right, but we're going to keep it for now because I'm pressed for time. Here we go, aiming at center chest to get you a grouping near the head, okay? Everything up here, this was the kneeling, okay? Kneeling supported position, so everything grouping pretty high, but way better once the weapon was actually zeroed, doing what you wanted to do here. And then last one, standing, okay? Here's your standing group, guys. Remember, ignore everything down here, okay? So it's just these rounds up here for the standing. Standing support, guys, all these rounds up here, these ones from the previous group. All right, guys, so if you like the content, don't forget to like, subscribe, do all the YouTube things. Remember, iron sights will get it done. Don't fall victim to the internet telling you you need the most expensive optic in the world. Just get out to the range and actually train the stuff you do have, guys. Check out the description for good stuff from PSA and Mystery Ranch. And if you want to become a member of the Discord channel to support future content when I run out to the range before work like this, check out the Patreon, guys. I could sure use your help. Till next time, this is going to be Trench Grenade signing out. Cheers.